doesn't always get full. I don't know. That's probably not what you're looking for, that kind of hands-on accountability, is it, Bill?
Well, actually, that's exactly what I want because I used to get the others.
What happens? Bill is, you know, the hardest part when you do this right, because you know what they're going to say, is to not laugh on the camera. Because who's selling who? When Bill says, that's exactly what I'm looking for. You guys heard the redirection? I only work with people who want these results. So you might want to say, you know, maybe you shouldn't work with me. You know, but I, and then you do, and so you don't have to be defensive all the time when someone attacks you. Let's go to another one. Are these good? Are these good role plays? If any, does anyone have one they want to just want to, silly, the perfect answer to silly prospect's question. Anybody have a silly prospect question they want us to tackle?
How did you get my phone number?
You know, I was at the Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Palace. I used the bathroom and it was on the wall. I want to have a good time and do business. And that's why I called you. I do things like, no, seriously. No, don't say things like that. So seriously, sir, I was thinking this. I have your number on my desk here on a post-it. What is this about? What are you selling? You called me.
Yeah, you called me. I mean, why? Like, how'd you even get this phone number? It's just, yeah.
I'm embarrassed to say I'm not really sure. You don't have a house. This isn't about real estate or something, is it?
I've been getting a lot of phone calls on this piece of real estate, so probably.
What piece of real? Oh, you have something for sale? You know what? Would you mind telling me about it? Is it land? Is it a storage center? Is it residential? What kind of land are we talking about?
Yeah, I've had this land. I listed it with an agent, but I got a bunch of lowball offers, so I just took it off of the market, and I've just been getting crazy phone calls from people for months.
Can I ask you two, three quick questions and I'll make you an offer? Would that be okay?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want, but I want my price. So, I
Okay.
mean,
Well,
it's
that's good for you, sir, and your price and your name and your prices. Boom. Okay. That's you could just go right into it. So sometimes we feign ignorance. Why are you calling me? How'd you get my number? I don't. Three most important word in sales. What are they?
I don't know.
I don't know what forces them to do when you, I don't know. Can you help me? And that's called a rescue. Okay. What does that force them to do? I don't know. Great question. Funny you brought, why am I calling? Are you looking to sell me something? I'm actually calling them. I know exactly what I'm doing, but I'm trying to keep them a little off balance and treat them a little differently. You know, and you can have a lot of fun with this too. This isn't about real estate, is it? And of course, you know it is. And you have a house. Oh, this isn't about. A lot of people call me about real estate. Eric, is this what we're talking about today? What do you have for sale? Boom. Start asking questions. Then you go into your agenda, regain control, and then you do your qualification. And if there's something, that make an offer. If not, dismiss them. Get off. But you stay in control rather than them treat you badly. Do you ever had it in the very beginning? They were a little, they're having a bad day. And you're like the third person to call or something. It's a bad Monday and they're a little snippy to you. Who's had that snippy prospect? You know, how do you handle the snippy prospect?
I had one just like that on Friday, Claude. They were was a couple psychologists. They were really withholding, really hesitant to open up. Kind of a referral. They already work with some of the people I've worked with in the past, and just really sound like they brought a lot of weight to the call, and just were, how can I help you? Oh, we're here for this. Well, help me understand. So how I handled it is I just gave them a lot of space. I used silence. I asked, help me understand. Are you stroking and nurturing? And at one point, she was getting a little upset, and I was just like, "Look, I'm sorry. I've never talked to you before. I don't understand. I need to get clarity on your situation so I can
Perfect.
see if I can help you or not.
Perfect.
Can you
Perfect
help me
answer.
understand?"
Yeah. Perfect answer, Bailey. Hey, listen, I want to help you here. I didn't come here to fight. I want to help you, but if I don't know what you want, why you need it, what your budget is, how can I help you? I'm not a mind reader. You said, you know what, Mr. Bailey, you sound like you're mad at me. Tell me what I did wrong so I can apologize. I just don't know what exactly what you'd like from me. Tell me what I did wrong first, and so I, you know, so I can say I'm sorry.
It's a great line. Love that. But yeah, worked out great. They were laughing by the end of the call, and then turned out to be a one call close. So thank you for what you do, sir. Appreciate it.
I always love this quote from my mentor. We turn chicken shit into chicken salad. How do we turn around? It started bad. It got worse. Can we turn it around?
Absolutely.
Yeah. You know, you sound like you're mad at me. You know, I must have screwed up or something. Tell me what I did wrong and I'll apologize. Boom. You know, like, can I send you a bottle of wine and we'll start all over again? You know, believe me, they never want you to send them a bottle of wine. But you got to, if you can't have that civil conversation, what's the odds that you're going to do business? It's nothing. Yeah. 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 It's a rainstorm. I got to use the rain for once. On there. So you got to stay. Thank you, Bailey. Excellent, you know, example of that. You know, you get them where they're just powering. Well, answer my question. And I don't understand the why are you asking this question? What are you looking for from me? What do you need from, what do you need in order to make a commitment or do business? Okay, that's showing expertise and authority. If we're totally, little psychology here, if we're totally submissive to the prospect, we just do everything they want. We're doing all this. What's the chances of closure, of doing business? I think it goes down rapidly in those situations.
Too desperate, right?
You sound desperate. Does anyone want to work with a desperate lawyer, doctor, accountant, dentist, a desperate professional? What goes through our mind when we get somebody who wants the business too bad? Where's our thinking? What happens to her? What do we think?
They're desperate. They'll do anything.
Yeah, they'll do anything. Maybe this isn't the right person. You know, Randy, thanks for all the information. And I'm going to shop. I'm going to talk to you, you know, I got appointments with a couple other people and everything, but you're a great guy. I got your card. Thanks so much. Boom. They just dismissed you like you're trying to borrow money or something. Okay. Do you think prospects sometimes want to get as much free information from us as possible so they can go and beat up our competition? Or?
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely. How do we regain control? How do we, you know, in the first place?
You have to redirect. Claude, I understand you. I know, I certainly understand you want to go out and get some other bids. That's great. I certainly hope you do. I mean, you know, just in order to know how good my prices are. Well, let me ask you a question. How soon are you planning to do this?
Price is my main thing. You guys are a little expensive. No offense.
Yes, sir. We are. We've been in business 30 years, same location. Prices are, you know, we have to stay in business. Like, I can't lowball something to where it's going to put me out of business. But let me ask you, how soon do you want this done? I mean, if I can get it done for you Thursday this week, and get it done before your grandkids come over and play on that crappy carpet you've had your five chihuahuas on for the last 20 years. If I can get it done for you by Thursday, what would you say then?
Well, that's a good point. I mean, the other company is about 10% cheaper than you. No offense, okay? But they can't do it until June. They won't have the stock until June. Is there any? Can you do any better on your price? If I give, you know. I love that question.
I might be able to get a little bit, but it won't be much, Claude. I'll tell you up front, it won't be much. I might be able to do a little bit better for you, but you're an intelligent man. You're a smart man. You do business all the time. You know, you get what you pay for in life.
Yeah. Is there's something, that was very good, Randy. Thank you. There's something when they want to negotiate price, sometimes you can do something called substitution. give them something else or change it around. Say, you know what? I can give you a lower price, but I'll have to move you out 30 to 40 days. You told me your family's coming, your daughter's having her wedding reception, and you need this carpeting. You know, normally we even charge a premium price for a rush job. But I'll tell you what, I made you a commitment. I'll hold you to it. We'll get it installed. You'll love it. Or you can tell me to, you can shop around and not have that ready for that special family occasion. Imagine how proud.
You mean I could just fire you? I could just fire you like that?
Sure. What happens when you push them away, but you tell them all the reasons, the emotional triggers, why they need to do business right now?
It's not reciprocity. It's more, I don't want to say peer pressure, but it's something Cialdini's come up with.
You know, in the conversation, he needs it fast. Okay. Speed, time frame is a very important qualifier to a lot of people, isn't it? In real estate?
It is.
Okay. We need to do it for tax reasons. We're having a party, whatever you're selling or anything. Is time a qualification that's important to find out? See, that's why I love role plays. We never talk about the time factor in doing business. Sometimes people need to buy or sell something within a constricted time frame. True?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And maybe your pricing is higher or delivery date is different from your competition. Can you use that to close them right? You know, sometimes people get stuck on price, true? They just get stuck on price. Yeah. I want the best price. I want the best. But there's other substitutions you can use. We can deliver it faster. We can give you a better guarantee or warranty with it. I don't know if that's important to you. Okay. And we can, you know, delivery time, things like that. These are all different issues. So sometimes when you're negotiating, substitute some other benefit you have when you're going for the close. But you want to do one more before we go, or should we go now? So that was a fast hour today. Should we do one more? Nod your head.
Uno mas.
One more. Uno mas. Hey, let's see. Who's been quiet? Who's been? Annette.
I'm here.
There you are. Annette, I'm really interested in selling my property to you. Can you call me later?
I'd be glad to. What's a good time for you?
Oh, I don't know. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I'm always home.
Okay, so let me ask you a quick question before I have to go.
I'm so sorry. I do want to talk to you. I do want to sell my land, but I really got to go. The dogs are at the door, man. I'm going to have an accident here. So I got 15 chihuahuas here.
Wow, that's a lot. That's definitely a lot. So let me see what we can do about scheduling this. What's a good time for you, morning or afternoons?
You call me tomorrow in the afternoon sometime. Anytime's fine.
Good. So are you the actual owner of the property?
Yeah, but I don't have time to talk about that right now. Yes, I am the owner.
Okay, good. How soon are you wanting to get rid of it?
As soon as possible. Listen, I really got to go. I'll talk to you tomorrow, okay? Say, listen,
okay.
Have a good day.
Good. I'll give you a call tomorrow.
Okay. What could happen? Now that I kind of threw on.
Are they going to be there tomorrow? No, of course not.
Well, that's why you got to set a time. Tomorrow, let's make it. I'll tell you, I got a very busy schedule. Let's make it 1:30.
Okay. Good.
Try to set that specific time and then send a text follow-up to lock it in or put it in your calendar and send a calendar reminder. Set a specific time because what's the danger when they just say, call me anytime, Tuesday or Wednesday? What does that really mean?
I mean, it's no time. Yeah.
Is there any, they'll forget about you. They'll do something else. They'll be easily distracted. But if they have a hard appointment and then you follow up on it, is there a better likelihood you'll get them again on that phone?
A little bit better, yeah.
Because don't we get situations like this? Oh, I want to talk to you. Oh, I'm glad you called, but I got to go or go somewhere.
Yeah.
Don't we get that? That's reasonable, right? We've all been in that situation. Or they're in the car. It's bad phone cell service or something like that.
Right.
See if you can set specific times. You guys are great. Is this the fastest hour you've ever seen? Mm-hmm. Just go quick. You guys are great. Good role plays. We learned a lot. Have a wonderful week. And.